Coach Mike McConathy, Demon basketball coach. It's here. It's season opening week. Your team has been through a lot of preparation over the last few months. Tell us what to expect from the Demons this season.
Well, I really think that there's a general feeling among most of the guys is that they're excited. I think that with the intensity level that they're playing with, it's been very, very encouraging. I think that we've got guys that are stepping up and doing things that sometimes they're being asked to do things that are a little bit maybe different, but for the best of the team, that, you know, they're doing that. And, you know, one thing, area we talked about rebounding this morning. You know, our guards had in a secret scrimmage, our guards had 6 and 6 rebounds apiece, and two wings actually had 6 and 6 rebounds, and we haven't been getting that. So if we can continue to get that kind of rebound production, because our bigs were in the secret scrimmage we had. I don't know why they call them secret scrimmages, but anyway, that's what they call them. We didn't get a lot of rebounding production out of our bigs, but a lot of that had to do with the fact that the team that we're playing was so large and long. Therefore, there were some rebounds that the guards could pick up, our wings could pick up, and that made a lot of difference.
Your team this year, style-wise, describe it.
I think it's more like we're accustomed to playing, with being able to rotate people in and competing at a high, high level. And I think that that's going to be really, really important for us to be able to keep the intensity up and really compete at a high, high level. And, you know, and just understand that everybody has a different role, and that role is adjusted game to game depending on matchups. And sometimes that's hard for team members as well as coaches sometimes to understand. We may need to make this little adjustment here to tweak this to be able to have more production.
Every team goes through an evolution each season with newcomers. This is a little more extreme than most, with 8 newcomers blending in with the core of your returning team. Talk about that process.
Well, I just think that, you know, I think our culture is really in good place right now. I think that the guys that have come in are hungry. I think the guys that are still here are have high character, and they're quality young men. And I think that that's helped a great deal to be able to do that. You basically got 8 and 8 is what it amounts to. And so it's a lot more positive. It's a lot more enjoyable to go to practice. When the spirit is good and kids are competing and they step up off the floor and really get after it, you know, and you want it to be fun for them. That's the most important thing. And, you know, I think that their attitude has been that, and I think they're doing a really good job with that. So we just got to maintain that. The difficult part of that is when you go into the season and you're headed into, you know, our opening run of Texas, Laterno, SMU, Rice, ULM, 5 games in a short period of time, you know, that's a wear and tear. But you still have a learning process that's going on, and that's what really makes it difficult in the early going, because you got to still get reps in at practice to go over things, but you don't want to wear people out because you got to compete in the games. That's one thing. When we have our wave system going really strong, that really makes a lot of difference, and it helps us be able to play 5 games in a short period of time.
Specifically, let's focus in on Friday night's game at Texas, a style of play that really will be fitting what you guys do, I would think.
Yeah, I mean, you know, they're going to press you and do a lot of different things. The one thing, long guys that press can be more effective, but they can also be less effective because of speed. If they're long and they're really fast, then you got a really, really big task ahead. But I felt like in our secret scrimmage, the bunch is really supposed to be pretty good at pressing. We had no trouble with their press at all, which we caused problems with our press, forcing 7 turnovers in our press. Our green own is what we call it. So that was a real positive thing. So heading into Texas, you know, that's there. They have, you know, a big time pro type center, and he's really, really good. I for sure can't pronounce his name. It's Mamamba or something like that. But, you know, some people aren't as talented as others.
Well, as long as you know what number to have the team defend, I think we're okay on that front. The home opener, Sunday against Laterno,
yes.
Doubleheader.
Yeah, that's great. The women and us are playing together at 2 and 4. really, really a good opportunity for people to come out and see what the ladies have and what we have.
Through the two secret scrimmages, anything that has surprised you about your team?
I really think we're playing a lot harder. I mean, that's been the biggest thing to me, is we just played so hard. And that's the first thing, that if you can get young men to play as hard as they can, it's going to have an impact on everybody, and just not on the people on the floor, because the other guys feel like they've got to go match that intensity when they're not on the floor. So I think that's a real positive thing. You know, we've had some really good interior play at times with Ishmael Lane and Larry Owens. Brandon Hutton's brought a different game. Darian Dixon's brought a different kind of game. Probably in the first secret scrimmage, they were a little bit more effective inside. Second scrimmage, our wings were a little bit more effective, simply because they were just huge in there, had a lot to do with it.
If there's one thing basketball-wise that your team is doing well right now above anything else, is there one thing you can zero out?
Well, you know, I say play hard, and that's indicative of what, if you play hard, the other things come. We still have got to get better at staying in front. We are contesting shots a little bit better than we've been doing. The one thing we are doing good, that is a good question, is rotating when there's guys, and we saw that in video this morning, when a guy gets beat, somebody helps up, guy rotates. You know, we kind of call it creating chaos of being in the right places. So the rotation, one thing that if we could learn to talk loudly and vocally on that, I think it would help us be a lot better team.
Well, we'll see if that'll happen starting Friday night. Thank you.